would now like to welcome Diana Bobrick, Caitlin Bergman, Sarah Gillespie, Priscilla Gomez, Berceda Perez Garcia, and Kelly Anderson to perform our national anthem with ASL signer Alani Medlock.
Thank you, singers. Welcome Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2022, HELA faculty members, friends, and family. We would like to thank first and introduce the Evergreen School District Board of Directors, President Ginny Gronwald, Vice President Julie Bocanegra, and directors Victoria Bradford, Rob Perkins, Jacqueline Weatherspoon, thank you. Thank you all for joining the Henrietta Lacks Class of 2020 this evening to celebrate our commencement. I am so proud to be a member of this accomplished graduating class. These 4 years have been long at times, but today it seems as though they went by in the blink of an eye. And that means that these next few years might feel like forever while you're living them, working hard for your degree or that paycheck, but at the end of the day, you will realize that they too went by fast. 4 years, if you're 18, is 22% of your life. That seems like a whole lot more if you think about it that way. Almost a quarter of your life, you've been shaped by the people sitting in front of and around you. Take them with you wherever you go. I think that's why we love those old pictures of ourselves so much. We love to see what we used to be like because we don't remember it anymore. In the journey you're about to embark on, be aware, not worrying that you'll forget everything and end up living in cautious need to document everything. Rather, simply be aware that time will go by and things will change, but the things to come may be even more exciting than those you're leaving behind. And if sometimes they feel like they're not, you'll always have the good old days of high school to look back on and smile about.
We are one of 26,407 public high schools that exist in the United States. And out of all those people, the people around you are the ones you got the privilege to meet and share memories with. We decided to attend a small school where strangers become family. It will be weird not seeing the usual faces in the hallways anymore. Memories can last for a lifetime, or they can last for a second. But in the end, what matters is the experience. Every time I look at each of your faces, it breaks my heart a little bit how much I appreciate every one of you. Through fun times and stressful times, we all share one memory, attending the same high school. Instead of when thinking about Mr. Thompson during freshman year, walking around with his music, and Ms. Doyle in her relaxed classroom, before the end of any other experience, I want to remind you that although change is difficult, in order to complete and reach your goals, you must start.
For the long or short time we had together, we are grateful. We are grateful for the teachers, counselors, principals, associate principals, and whoever that district guy, Mr. Thompson and Mr. Conrad are, that sing the Gila song every single Friday. We are grateful for our peers, us, the class of 2022, for the year spent at Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School. We are grateful to get to use our respectable name when someone asks us where we go, or now, where we graduated from. Using the full name of our school, you might just get hired on the spot. As this chapter in our life comes to a close, a world full of opportunities awaits every one of us. So, whether you're taking a gap year to travel the country, enlisting in the military, entering the workforce, or continuing your education, enjoy yourself, have fun, apply your unique skills to the opportunities that await you, and never doubt your potential. Congratulations, class of 2022. Welcome to your graduation. Class of 2022, I would now like to introduce School Superintendent John Boyd.
Good evening and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class at Gila High School of 2022. Congratulations, graduates. Let's give them a big hand. I think this downpour is really just kind of a last test for you, as if you haven't had many, many tests before you over the last 2 years during this pandemic. But I want to just tell you how impressed we are with your perseverance, your strength of character, and the fact that you've made it to this point in your educational career. We could not be more proud of your accomplishment today. I would also like to just recognize the staff. If we could have the staff stand up, I think we need to give the staff one big hand. If you could stand up, I know it's tough with the umbrellas. Thank you so much for all of the support, guidance, love, and care that you've given to our students here. And none of this would have happened without the support and the love of our family and our parents and all of our friends here today. So graduates, if you could just give, I was gonna make you stand up, but I'm not gonna do that in the rain, but let's just give your family a round of applause, your friends and your family, and for their support. And thank you so much. Congratulations to the class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Boyd. I would now like to introduce our first class speaker, Olivia Farnsworth.
Good evening, Phoenix family. Before I begin, I would like to thank everyone who came out to support the graduating class of 2022. Without you, we wouldn't be here today. I would also like to say how honored I am to have the opportunity to represent my class on this stage. After all that we've gone through together over the past 4 years, I hope I can do us justice. When I first started writing my speech, I thought about doing something similar to the speech I delivered at my eighth grade graduation, paying tribute to the staff members who had made my time there special. However, when I started compiling a list of all the people at Gila who've made me smile and helped me to grow over these past 4 years, I realized I could just save time and just copy and paste the staff directory off the school website. So I started thinking about the universal experiences of our class. And the more I analyzed what is now our origin story to adulthood, the more parallels I saw between our story and that of our mascot, the Phoenix. Following this idea, I did some research into how we chose the Phoenix. During our first year, back in 2013, Helixes were responsible for creating proposals for different mascots. Among these initial proposals were the rooster, the narwhal, the bear, and of course, the phoenix. Now, I'll admit that I'm biased, but I just don't think that Joaquin Narwhal has the same ring to it as Joaquin Phoenix. After the Helixes put forth their candidates, the students and staff voted and selected the Phoenix to be our mascot. Our community was inspired by the values of the Phoenix and felt that its legacy of immortality tied closely to the legacy of Henrietta Lacks and her Gila cells. Our now iconic logo was designed by Lee Emmert, our founding photography teacher, and our mascot costume was gifted to our school by the graduating class of 2020. Like our student body, the modern adaptation of the Phoenix legend has roots in many different cultures from all over the world. In the popular Western legend, only one Phoenix would live at a time, with each bird having a lifespan of about 500 years. When the Phoenix was nearing the end of its life, it would build a nest and burn itself. Then the next generation of the Phoenix line would rise from the ashes, renewed and even more spectacular than before. Unlike the Phoenix, we did not see the end approaching. We were naive, denying the significance of our expanded spring break. We did not burn by choice, but we did choose to get up and start again in our new reality. Many of us came to Gila with goals like straight A's, top 10%, getting only fives on AP exams, club leadership roles, and Ivy League acceptance letters. That was who we were at the beginning of our journey. We give a lot of commendation to the students who achieved and exceeded their original goals, and they are fully deserving of every bit of praise. But they aren't the only ones who fought hard to get here today. I think we can all agree that the past few years of COVID, protests, and global conflict have amounted to an awesome, well, dumpster fire. Many of us burnt out in the flames of remote, hybrid, and constant societal distress. We lost our 4.0s and our precious class rank. But for some of us, when we lost our facade of perfection, we got to see who we really are, what really matters to us. Previously buried characteristics sprouted, leaving us more prepared for the challenges of adulthood. We adapted in order to survive in this new world. Some of us found jobs or hobbies that will become our careers. Others, like me, haven't necessarily seen all our cards, but we know how we'll play our hand. We had to burn who we thought we were in order to get down to the ashes, the source, the essence of our character. We needed to start back at that level in order to rise again, renewed in who we are as individuals. Wiser and more resilient, ready to take the lessons of Gila and rise above. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivia. And now here's our senior choir ensemble performing We Remember Them. Thank you, Gila Senior Choir Ensemble. I would now like to introduce our second student speaker, Andy Santos.
Okay, this thing on? It's on. All right, hello friends and family. Thank you all for joining us here today to celebrate the graduating class of 2022. My name is Andy Santos, and I would like to take this opportunity to first and foremost thank both my lovely parents. You are truly the reason why I have the courage to stand before this amazing audience. And to my sister, Tare, thank you for being the shoulder to lean on during these 4 years of high school. It feels like just yesterday I was here watching you walk across these steps and cheering you on. It feels like such a lifetime ago, and now you get to see me. I hope I make you proud. The first week of high school is almost always marked by difficulty. The questions of high school flow through our brains with ease. How am I going to get through this? Who will be my friends? Will I truly fit in? Can anyone truly understand me? Can I understand myself? These anxieties bounce around our heads until the first day of high school, and we quickly realize something. For us HeLa students, our greatest adversary wouldn't be anyone or ourselves. It would be the stairs. 3 flights, 4 stairwells, with about 250 steps in total between all of them. Yes, I did in fact count all of them. Every senior knows these steps well. Every week, every day, every class period, we were given a reason to transfer out of this school. But we didn't. When I was a freshman, I asked an upperclassman, how do you get through it every day? First period, first floor, second period, third floor, you might end up in the fifth. You don't know. And so they simply looked at me and said, one thing, the steps don't get any easier. You just learn to push through them one step at a time. I more than likely laughed at this at the time. Easily one of the corniest lines I have heard in such a long time. But I'm coming to find out that those words hold a truer sentiment now more than ever. If our senior class can be marked by anything, it's adversity. Over the years, school quickly exited the minds of everyone as we try to find new ways to simply exist in peace. Lectures turned to recorded meetings, and social interactions became a few sporadic messages during Zoom calls. Then finally, as the seasons changed and leaves began to fall, we found ourselves in the midst of our junior year. Junior year, being the pivotal year in our high school experience where we finally transitioned from older kids to young adults, was done over a screen, and we saw each other's lives through pictures on Instagram. And it wasn't until February where we began to see each other's faces in person once again. And here we are now, 819 days later. But adversity marks our senior class. It must also be coupled with an overwhelming sense of hope and unwavering determination. As we came back together, we found it in ourselves to start to rebuild what had been lost. We refused to let our community stay in shambles and progressed. Those years of clubs not meeting quickly turned into revamped meetings. How can we bring people together again? How can we make people more engaged in our communities? What's the next step here? And we quickly discovered something, that the next step didn't include us as much. It was time to not only move on, but to start to take a look at what we would leave behind. So again, we changed and adapted and made sure our conversation started getting phrased into for next year students, for next time. And this ideal persistence of hope is what I believe our legacy is. What we pass on to the next wave of students is our defining factor. People may not remember our faces or our names, but they will remember how we made them feel. Those times we walked down our school halls, we must think back and acknowledge not only how we acted and what words we chose to say, but beyond that, what our actions reflected on us as people. Because maybe one day some random freshman that heard those words from a senior will be telling that story at graduation in hopes that our legacy is segmented as something greater than us, something that our future generations can build off of. But this train of thought can't exactly be credited completely to us alone, but to those that came before us. And I'm not talking about our past alumni, but a bit further. To those that raised us, to our parents and guardians, They are the foreshadowing of who we are and who will become in the future. And for me, I wish to be like my parents, especially my mother, my mom, my hero. It's raining, that's why my eyes are getting watery, don't worry. It was maybe a few years ago when I asked about my grandfather for the first time, and immediately saw my mother's face soften to an expression that spoke more than words could ever. But surprisingly, or unsurprisingly, she did in fact have words to match, and told me about a man whose wisdom extended beyond the grave, and beyond the tree, and beyond the tombstone, thousands of miles away in his final resting place. And spoke words that instilled me with such great passion that it inspired me to stand before you today. I was talking to my mother about being terrified about giving the speech, and the cliche thoughts of what if this goes horribly wrong, and the UW's admission counselors email on me on the spot and they say, after hearing your speech, or the poor excuse of one, you are instantly rejected from our college. Okay, well, maybe not the most cliche thoughts. And so my mother stared at me. And all the lessons that my grandfather taught her as a child, she decided to teach me in that moment. And the conversation I had when asking about him resurfaced. And so she said, so what if you fail? Más vale que vas, que ves, que trates, que pruebes, que alguien te regrese y te cuente. And for those of you that don't understand Spanish, this saying almost directly translates to, it is worth more for you to go, to try, to see, to taste, than for someone to come back and tell you about it. It is my grandfather's words that were spoken half a century ago to ears that weren't my own that drive me. In the process of simply trying without fear of failure, do we truly gain something more than trivial success? We learn courage to take the next step, determination to continue in the face of adversity, and hope in the face of uncertainty. And that is the future as we finally take our next few steps into the future. And now we again have a chance to cement our legacy onto this world. So, what will your legacy be? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Andy. I would now like to introduce our final speaker, the fantastic Sophia Sofji.
Good afternoon, administrators, teachers, staff members, parents, and most importantly, Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School, class of 2022. Thank you to everyone filling the stands, cheering us all along on our journey beyond high school and on to the next chapter today. I am beyond honored to be standing before you today, looking at my friends and my family, and getting to say, congratulations, we made it, as I flipped a page with all of you today. I am standing on this McKenzie Stadium stage and staring back at 105 faces. 105 faces I have gotten to watch grow, change, and become the graduates we see today. Wow. I have always lived in the same world as everyone else, listening to similar music, sharing the same experiences, and living through my own set of adverse childhood experiences. I know what I came to do, and that is not going to change. What I came here to do in this world is not only to live, but to love, to listen, to rise above, to improve, to learn, to share passions, to share experiences, and most importantly, to make others feel happy, no matter what is going on in my life. You've heard it said, breathe in blue skies, breathe out gray skies. This means you breathe out all your negative frowns and breathe in the world's supply of happiness. Rather than expelling negative energy, I believe in taking in the blue skies of other people, every dimple on every cheek, and cultivating your own blue sky you share with others. Blue skies in, blue skies out. It means breathing in positive and breathing out positive. So many times I was walking the halls and it was the little things that let me brighten someone's day. Whether it was helping someone open up their lockers, since they're way harder than they need to be, or simply complimenting their work. By doing all of this, I not only improved my own mindset and mood, but I also made someone else happy. All it takes is a single second, 43 muscles, and just a little focus. You matter and make a difference by being here right now. Yes, I mean right here in the very stadium you are sitting in. Now, more than ever, that truly is all it takes to change the course of someone else's day, and in turn, yours. Gila High School, I ask you, how will you cultivate and thrive in your blue skies in, blue skies out? What if I told you all it took was a single second, a single moment of your routine life to change the course of someone else's day? All it takes is 1 second to focus on the present and what is right in front of you. The more we focus on each other, not on appearance or values or beliefs, but truly focus on a soul-connected level, we begin to notice how much we all have in common. All motivated, mutually interdependent, and supportive phoenixes living together in a community. All interconnected without even realizing. Every unique feature and smile mark, we're all so alike. We came to the school, some of us forced by our parents, others actually wanting to be here, and as soon as we got here, all of our opinions changed. We made friends we didn't know we would make. We joined clubs, some of us 5, and dressed up for spirit weeks. Some of us made it through 4 years without falling down the stairs, others didn't. We were put into a high school different from the rest. We were put into an environment with caring teachers, supportive classmates, nursing mannequins that I swear I heard talking once, and a balcony that never really was open. Attending Gila has opened up so many doors that have allowed us to rise above. We, as the class of 2022, have chosen to rise above by helping others feel safe to be themselves, to laugh however hard they want, to cry as many tears are as needed, and to be happy for as many moments as we can, and to realize that life is worth living and should be viewed with the adoration of 7 billion graces. We did that, Gila. You have each gone through your own 4-year journey, each person with their own smiles and their own frowns, as Ms. Martin would say, a different set of accomplishments and hurts for each cap facing me in the audience. But we all share one thing in common, the willingness to keep going. We came back to school stronger than ever and continued to dress up for spirit weeks, work on our finals, and show up for the people that needed us here. We all share a strive for excellence and making it through a year, series of years unlike any seen before, a global pandemic. A global pandemic not only left us out of school to quarantine elsewhere, but it left us with an uncertainty that was beyond anything we were able to process. There is no how-to on getting through a global crisis. And how many memories we lost. Those memories we have tried to reinvent and make this year. So much pressure. These last 3 months have gone by so fast. Everyone was counting down the days to this moment right here, and now we wish we had it all back. If only we can go and get a second chance, go back and face regrets, make amends, work harder, make time for ourselves, and do it differently. But then, we wouldn't have all the experience we have today. Quarantine taught me a lot. It taught me to love those who are near me harder, to cherish memories with those now far away, and to work at the relationships and friendships right in front of us. Beyond this, quarantine created relationships with people like no other. We learned to love everyone and understand that they might be going through something you cannot see. We learned to find our own motivation for school. It was so easy to log on to my AP Physics lecture in the morning, camera off, fast asleep. But I learned that that didn't really end well. So I got up, made my Dalgona coffee, changed out of pajamas I never took off, and actually tried. Tried to keep up with assignments. Tried to stay positive in a dark place. Tried to make it through a junior year that really kicked all of our butts. And although some of our paths may be different, a lot of them may look the same. We are all smart, capable, and really strong individuals. We made it through what felt like rock bottom, an adjustment from in-person learning, seeing faces, emotions, and smiles, to the behind-the-scenes tragedy that meant no interactions and no contact, complete isolation. Gila, we made it through that. We can make it through anything now. Our time is not yet over. Our future is right in front of us. Reach out and grab it. Take advantage of whatever you want, college, a job, the start of your life. It is whatever you want to make of it now. Where will you end up? Where will we end up? I am so proud of all of you, Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2022.
All right, thank you, Sophia. I would now like to introduce our principal, Amy Haynes, to present the class of 2022.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, faculty members, and especially the graduates of the class of 2022. Graduates, as you know, our school motto is Rise Above. We say this a lot, and we strive to embrace it in our actions. This year, Rising Above meant persevering in a time when we thought the hardest years were behind us. COVID restrictions were lifted, and we were finally allowed to be with one another again. Back in the building and back at a school that had held so many fond memories for us. We were so excited to go back to the way we were, to continue what we had started and to get back to more of the same prior to the pandemic. But when we arrived, we found that who we were prior to the shutdown had fundamentally been changed. The pandemic put us in isolation and forced learning and social conditions that left us academically frustrated and isolated, away from our teachers and friends. For many of us, once we were back at school, it stole our confidence in navigating our studies and our friendships that had come so easy for us before. This was a shock. We had expected things to be the same, but our seniors led the charge in starting the work of getting us back. You met with me and asked for change in ways that made our school better. You identified systems that needed to be tweaked, and you did the hard work of planning and implementing community building to bring us back. You did all of this after losing 2 years of your traditional high school experience. You fought through your own struggles to make sure that you were present to do the work of restoring the Henrietta Lacks community. I am so proud of the advocacy skills you brought to your school, our school, and the work you did to make our school the best it can be. We also know that Rising Above is about being of service to others, whether that is to your peers, your patients, or the greater community. Throughout this year, this group devoted thousands of hours to formal community service, such as serving the homeless community, coordinating blood drives, volunteering with families at Peace Health, and participating in neighborhood cleanups. These weren't things that you all just signed up for, but opportunities you created and built on your own accord through your own innovation and wanting to do right by others. You made these opportunities happen by seeing a need and filling a need. Another reason I am so proud that you are ours. I am proud to call you Gila graduates. One last thing. As the principal of this school, I made a commitment to share this important message with every graduate that leaves our school community. This message is truth, so hear me out. Your road ahead will not be easy. There will be difficult times. You will have stress, challenges, and obstacles. There will be times when you will feel insecure, an inner voice will give you doubt, or a systemic barrier will land in your path. In these moments, I want you to remember that you deserve to reach your goals. You deserve a place in that college, in that industry, or at that decision-making table. And when you feel yourself shrinking, when up against what may seem like countless obstacles, I want you to visit us, call us, or email us. I want you to reach out to us so we can remind you of how capable and valuable you are, that the world needs people like you in leadership positions, and that you belong wherever you want to be. You are part of this family for life, and we have your back. Henrietta Lacks High School will always be in your corner. And now to get to the real reason y'all came here tonight. As principal of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School, it is my privilege to confirm that these students receiving their diplomas tonight will have met the requirements of the state of Washington and the standards set forth by the Evergreen School District. Members of the Board of Directors and Superintendent John Boyd, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2022. We're going to move the podium.
So Riley Aquavendez is our vice president. And then Bailey was our treasurer for our class.
So I'm reading all three of those to start?
So you read it in order, mm-hmm. but when you read Riley, you read her title, vice president, and when you read Bailey, you read her title, treasurer.
Okay.
Everything else is just reading.
And so they're getting their diplomas?
Yes.
Okay.
You start with us, but that you're doing them as well.
Okay. All right.
It is first my honor to present the diplomas to the 2022 senior class officers. First, Olivia Farnsworth. Maria Garcia Cueva. And Sophia Sofci. Now for the diplomas of our top 10%. Riley Alcabendas, Vice President. Angela Cortez Salinas. Bailey Cunningham, Treasurer. Priscilla Gomez. Tressa Hughes. Avinash Kaur. Kyle Martin. Alani Medlock. Brooklyn Schumacher. Shoemaker.
Okay. Who's that? Names?
And Andy Santos. And now we'd like to welcome up the rest of the graduates. Lena Agafonova.
Kelly Anderson.
Yulisa Ariola Aguilar. Josue Barrera. Yeah.
Anita Berberian.
Caitlin Bergman.
Diana Bobrick.
Tristan Bowles. Kevin Brown. Ethan Bowie. Jaden Campbell.
John Chechka.
Thomas Cha. Olivia Clark.
Caleb Kojikaru.
Madison Camilla. Isabella Cortez. Daniel Cragen. Our secretary, Selena Doe. Joseph Davis. Hayden Joseph Day. Kaylee Reve Ellett. Hannah Fletcher.
Nazar Fursik.
Janet.
Carla Janet Garcia Lopez. Brian Gillens. Sarah Gillespie.
Nikita Gladko.
Vianne Gomez Acosta. Cameron Grover.
Olga Guzenko.
Joshua Hernandez. Colton Hess. Isabel Hill. Joel Iblings. Brooklyn Kinder.
Kalaji.
McKinley Kalaji. Ryan Coppler.
Avelina Ismailova.
Gunnar LaForce. Michelle Madariaga.
Elizaveta Manyukina.
Colin Martin. Isabel Martinez. Leonardo Martinez. Keone Micah. Madeline Miller. Nicholas Murray. Noah Myers. Kaimana Nakagawa. Isabella Nelson. Angel Nino. Caitlin Olson. Aaliyah Ortega. Dario Pashalic. Berceda Perez Garcia. Maria Poloshenko. Angela Portansky. Wyatt Price. Adriana Puckett. Anaid Maria Ramirez Bereleza. Anthony Ramirez Urida. Basti Rodriguez. Monique Romero. Desley Rosas. Erica Salonga. Joseph Schwarzai. Edward Shukin. Sydney Schaff. Tyler Smith. Brittany Alexa Soria Mejia. Haley Risenstall.
Tapia.
Andrew Tapia Campos. Avery Thamer. And our public relations manager, Emily Tiproxe. Sam Duke Sawan. Angelina Turchina. Angelina Turchina. Jessica Bolasenko. Jordan Watson.
Morgan Weaver. Matthew Webb. And our ASB president, Amario Summerette Willard. Bella Williams. Levi Winslow. Brianna Wolf. Aaliyah K. Wright. Ryan Young. Kevin Zamora Sanchez.
Merari Zavala Prado.
Time to move the podium.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our graduating class of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School. Class of 2022, turn your tassels! Thank you. Before we conclude this evening's ceremony, we would once again like to thank you all for being here tonight to share this moment with the class of 2022. For those of you heading back to Gila, buses will load by Cascade Middle School immediately following the conclusion of the ceremony. Parents, please stay seated while the graduates leave and you will pick them up on the access road between Evergreen High School and Cascade Middle School. Thank you, everyone. Drive safely, and good night.
And finally, for the last time, let's get the Gila High graduates to sing the Gila song one more time from the top.
Bum, 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 we are from Gila High School, up and out of Phoenix. We're from Gila High School and the future is ours. We're bright, we're true, there's nothing we can't do. We sparkle and we shine in every way. Hey, 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 we're scholars, we're leaders.